Last week, again, Joe, during the discussions, you mentioned to me the opportunities that the current pandemic would offer for global universities who are opting online education. So how do you see universities alliances in future? Could you please elaborate on that?
I think we all agree that the pandemic has been a driver for change. And I think a good example is the Indian government recognizing, you know, the top 100 institutions in India and their online programs. And if you put that alongside Coursera, you know, FutureLearn, you know, I think there's only going to be more and more opportunities for online learning for universities worldwide. I think the advantage of the global networks is the expertise in the world-leading areas, world-leading institutions in specific areas. So we were talking about, you know, maritime, global change, public health, these areas. So if you get these universities sharing modules on master's degrees, they've already been developing archives, they've got virtual seminars for teaching postgraduate research, they provide virtual master's classes. So I think what I would say is that these networks are already delivering in that respect, okay? So an example is online master's programs, digital tools to support communication and collaboration among researchers, virtual seminars, cloud-based servers to easily share data and information. So these are already in place before the pandemic and enabled partners to quickly respond when the pandemic hit to start doing research on student learning during COVID, developing digital clinical skills resources. So I think that's a really interesting one. We are all challenged with online learning. How do doctors, how do physiotherapists, you know, how do people that have to do hands-on face-to-face learning cope in a virtual environment? So there's a lot of research going on in that. And there's also digital capacity to respond to current and future challenges in global education. So I think what I'm trying to really stress is that global networks already have a kind of an ecosystem where they can be doing this to create new innovations. So I think it's going to enable these networks and partner institutions to move very quickly on new and creative methods to deliver online learning. And I also very strongly believe that the kind of idea of stackable qualifications will benefit from a network, because you can actually then have, you know, a number of multiple sort of world-class universities offering that kind of structure. Particularly, I think we were talking about this as well, Nitin, earlier, how the pandemic has changed the professional working conditions for the foreseeable future. So how are people going to be getting their qualifications going forward? I think Reid's point is we've got an opportunity to recreate higher education after the pandemic. It's not about recreating, it's about reimagining it. And I think the networks really are going to be a really good place to do that.